which is the dogs all think that the dogs all think that the sound recording equipment is food for them for some reason. Guys, okay. I got rid of the dogs. Okay, so bum 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 bum. Bun means the bottom, like in Bundoran. I'm trying to get through these faster now. Carn means a heap of stones. So there's a place called Carnlough, and if I looked at Carnlough anglicised, I might think, oh, Carn is a heap of stones and Lough is a loch, is a lake. But actually it just comes from Carnlough, which is in the Irish, it originally just means a place where there is a heap of stones. And I'm just including that to say that it's when you're trying to figure out what place names originally meant from the English, you can go wrong because of the way they've been anglicised. So you need to go back to the original Irish and work it out from then, from there usually. And it's easy enough when you live in Ireland because the place names are often bilingual, if they're correct. And you can, it's easier to work out from them. So that's just to be careful. There actually is no loch in Carnlough. It's just the anglicised version makes it look that way. What's next? Carrig is a rock. So Carrick Fergus, it's anglicised as Carrick. And Carrick Fergus would just mean Fergus's rock. Kill means a church. So that's anglicised as K-I-L. But also Quill, which is means like a forest, will be anglicised as K-I-L as well. So if something is like, say, Kildare, comes from Kildara, which means the church of the oak. But sometimes it could come from a forest, so it's good to look back to the original Irish to check. Clun, when Clun is an Irish place name, it comes from Cluain, which means a meadow. So there's a place in Dublin called Cluain Tarrig, which means the meadow of the bull. And then there's a place, one of my favourite place names in Ireland is Cluain Mala, which is Clonmel. And in Irish, you can see much closer what it actually comes from, which is the meadow of honey. So beautiful. I love that place name so much. Knock is a hill. So the famous place in Mayo, Knock, comes from Knock. It just means a hill. That's where there's a famous shrine. And what else? In Galway, there's a place called Knock na Cathrach. So in Irish, it's really clear, Knock na Cathrach, the hill of the city. And it's just outside the city of Galway. But in English, it's Knock na Cara, so you'd lose the meaning. Donny or Downy comes from Downoch, which you might recognise as De Luan, De Mart, De Cadine, Deirdine, De Hina, De Saharan, De Downig. It means Sunday, but Downoch means a church. So Donnybrook, say in Dublin, comes from Downoch Brook. And in my head, like I never really thought about what Brook was, but if I'd be cycling through Donnybrook or something and see the sign, I'd say Brook, oh, like a badger. I don't know, I just had a link in my head because Brook does mean a badger. But when I was researching for this video, I looked it up and Brook is actually a saint and is a woman. So it's the church of Brook, this female saint. And it's like a really ancient name actually. And it's really interesting. So I'm gonna have to research more on that and maybe do, I don't know, a video or write an article about it because it's really interesting. But that's exactly why it's great to understand the place names and look into them because it gives you this history of the place that otherwise you're blind to. Drim. So when you see drum in an Irish place name, it comes from drim. If you know what part of the body that is, it's your back. So the way I remember what that means is I imagine someone's back like curved over because drim means like a ridge, like a hill. Then dún in Irish is anglicised as dún, and you have that in like Dunleary or Dundrum. So Dundrum is from dún and then drim, which is Dundrum is dún and drim together. So it's the fort of the ridge. And if you've ever been to Dundrum, you'll know that there is a hill there. Fionn means like fair or white. The colours in every language aren't necessarily divided in the same way. So let's just say Fionn means kind of something that's white, clear, bright kind of colour. So there's a famous park in Dublin called Phoenix Park, and that actually doesn't come from a phoenix at all. The Irish is Park on Hion Ishka, which is the park of the fair water, the clear water. And that, when that was anglicised, I suppose, they just wanted to find an English word that sounded like Hion Ishka, so they said Phoenix. Glown is Irish for glen, so that literally means a glen. I don't know if your version of English uses glen. Maybe that's Hiberno English. It's hard to tell when you speak Hiberno English. So it means like a valley. So a glen. So there's a place, a famous place in Ireland called Glen de Loch, and that's Glown da Loch. So Glown is the valley, da is two, and then Loch is a lake. So it's the valley of the two lakes, and there are two lakes there, literally. Inish means island, And that would be famous for like the Aran Islands. The biggest one, and Kaunas Mo, is called Inish Moor. That's anglicized as Inish Moor as well. It's just spelt differently. So it's literally Big Island, because there's three islands and the biggest one is called Inish Moor. Liss means a ring fort, like Listool, which is Listowel in Kerry. Loch means a lake, we've said that before, like with Glendalough. But also, like, if you have like the Loch Ness Monster, that's the same. It comes from Loch. You know, it's obviously that's in Scotland, but it's the same idea.